Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be teaching you how you can get a clay-looking 3D model rendering from Lumion. All right, so I've imported my moon house into Lumion, and the thing that really, I love Lumion so much, but it did sort of bother me. There wasn't an option to get like a clay model rendering like you see so often in concept models and things like that, because it has like the sky. So this is actually the white preset. Let me just open that really quick. If you go to start, when Lumion first opens, you'll see that there's this white. That's what I selected for this. But you get a blue sky, and there's no option, as far as I'm aware, to change the color of the sky. So it's sort of what you're stuck with. Even if you render as a styrofoam model, which I'll show you later, you still get a blue sky. So the trick to getting around this, if you want like an all black background, or you just want your concept photo, is to cheat. And I'm going to show you how to do that. So if you open SketchUp, I have this dynamically linked. You just sort of have to go old school with this. So I'm going to draw a plane here, and then choose a vertical line, or make a vertical line. And bring that over here. That should be a face now. Yep. And then I'm going to choose the arc tool. Make sure that I'm in this direction. It's not the right tool. Let's try this one. Yeah, there we go. That's much better. So that's what I want. I want that little arc, and then I'm just going to extrude this, or push-pull this, excuse me, along that. So I get a really nice smooth transition between the horizontal and the vertical surface. I'm just going to extrude this up, or move it up, rather. And then make this a group. So it looks pretty good. Now you just need to basically extrude this so that it covers everything that you're going to be looking at. So if I go back to Lumion, come in here, and you can see that we have a really nice gray model. Now what might happen is this could be white. You just want to make sure that that plane here is not above your ground plane, or below it, rather. And then you just sort of adjust this as you need. You can see in that it needed to be longer. This needs to be higher. And this isn't, it's not increasing the poly count at all, just because it's larger. It's actually the same amount of polygons. So it is slightly annoying that it has to be so massive, but it gets you what you're looking for. And I can be, right up on this, and I can change the angle a fair amount and still get that gray look. And I'm just going to move this down a teeny tiny bit, just enough so that I get a shadow. And you can actually see here that my object is going through the ground. So you just take this, hit F, and you move it up. But you'll notice that I'm getting a shadow down here. So you need to put in some lighting if you want to get rid of that. So I like to use the, what is this called? Area light. So just put in that area light, make it as big as you can, and then rotate it. I like to put the brightness pretty high, rotate it so that it's going on the horizontal surface. And just make sure it's up. Right. So we've got that guy. And you may just want to undo movement. I just want to move it this way. You just mess with it until you get what you want. You can see that that shape gets rid of that shadow that I didn't want. And then if you need to put in another one, you can always, is it shift? I think it might be alt. Undo movement. Alt, yeah. Just select this. Let's go to zero. Right. And just move it how you need to get what you're looking for. You can see there that the that curve pretty much disappeared completely. Now, I don't have any lighting on my model, but you can always fix that as well. If you needed to, you could make duplicates of this as well, because it kind of is giving me the light that I want, just not over here. We're just going to add in one more light, just so that our lighting doesn't suck. I'll just make another area light. I'll just make another one. Let's bring it over here. Then I'll bring it up. Then I'll target it. This is more like a sun at this point, right? And you can always change the, you know, use the sun as well if that's what you want. So we have this, and you can certainly render this. Obviously, I would copy this, these two guys off in the distance, make a group of this or something. Group it, and then maybe Shift-Alt. That didn't quite work how I wanted it to. But just make a copy of those. You guys know how to do that. Come back here. Okay, so we have this guy. Then if you want to render, I already have it applied here. Let me just get rid of it. This is kind of what it would look like. You can always mess with your focal length and your camera to get the exact sort of thing that you're looking for. But then you just come into custom style, or actually FX. And then under this tab up here, this is various, there is the styrofoam look. And you can change the amount of diffusion, change the color if you want. If you wanted it to be more red, you can certainly do that. Or like a blue look is always kind of cool. And you just mess with those sort of things, and then you can render. And it gives that conceptual render without all that stuff in the background. This is just looks like a floating thing. And you know, you could copy the light out here so it's the same amount of brightness, or this would give you a really great background that you could just Photoshop out if that's what you want to do. Alternatively, instead of this being white, you know, you could change, I don't know how easy it is for you to change all of the colors of this, of your actual model, but you can make the backdrop green. So maybe in the actual model, you change it so that it has no texture, and then render the background so you can just select the background. Thirdly, you can also do it so that when you export, you can export the lighting map. The lighting map seems to be the thing that is best for creating these sort of things. So I'm gonna type moon test. Okay, so I'm gonna open this folder now. Now when I look at, you actually can't see it because it looks that way. But let me find a different rendering that we did that on. Yeah, so you can see this is the lighting map that we did on the snow office. And it has a black background instead of the sky. So alternatively, if you want to try to Photoshop that out, you could just export with that lighting map and try to Photoshop that out. But I'm not really a big fan of the whole black thing. I like this look as a concept, but yeah. But anyway, hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers. Just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.